Hi, I'm Denis Brown, artist, calligrapher and creator of Calligraphy TV, and I'd like to introduce my program to you. The program is subtitled Expanding Writing Dynamics. And in many ways, this is what it's all about. I'll coach you in my dynamic pen strokes to help your calligraphy be more than pretty and to come alive and live and breathe with expression.
Calligraphy may be like sportsmanship, and this program will prove it.
The program presents loads of basic advice as well as advanced techniques. Your job is not to write with my dynamics, but to gradually increase your own as you're able. In this context, the program is for calligraphers of all levels of experience.
Now I have the main menu system. Scrolling down, each heading here links to a different module of the program. Compressed italic. Freeing the rhythm. Get polyrhythmic. Layering for polyrhythms. And just off screen below is a module featuring guest artist calligraphers. I'll click on Compressed Italic. That links to the first two modules, Italic Theory and Practice, and the Alphabet Demonstrations. The Theory and Practice heading links to a submenu, and each heading here links to a movie explaining principles to help you avoid slavish copying of letter forms. These movies will help you understand what you're doing. I'll click this heading to launch a movie. This program presents a particular form of italic, yet the principles may be applied to any form. Following are some general considerations regarding the structural relationship between two key letters, the N and the O. These have been described as the parent letters of the alphabet, since most other letters can be derived from these. Many people consider the letter O in italic as an oval. For some italic forms, this may be correct, but an oval won't fit the rhythm of other italics. I'll return to the italic menu and click for the alphabet. Okay, the letter V movie. A lot of technique here is explained in earlier movies, but this sample shows a mix of basic advice and also some advanced pen strokes.
I'll demonstrate the letter V next to this letter N. As always, it's a good idea to refer any new letter we're practicing back to the basic letter like an N or a U. So the principle of the V group has a problem fitting the rhythm being the pattern of equal distance parallel lines, because obviously, the V group, including W, X, and Y, the strokes are not parallel. To fit the rhythm as much as possible, it's important that the downstrokes match the thickness of the downstrokes of letters like N, even though there's a slight difference in direction. Another problem to be aware of is that many students make the first stroke of the V or W lean backwards far too much. Because there's a forward lean on the italic letters, the backward lean of W or V is reduced because that backward lean is leaned forwards a little bit, if you know what I mean. So I'm going to start with the serif. Again, I like to use a corner serif. It's the same angle as the other serifs, and it's a little flick on the corner. Now, to make the downstroke, which will be this direction, to make that the same thickness as the other downstrokes, there will be a pen angle change. So to get a good connection, I'll start with the same pen angle, but there'll be a quick twist into a steeper pen angle. I'll do that stroke now. And there's an extra little twist at the very bottom. So notice the angle of the stroke is very slightly less than this, but not so much. If your italic has a forward slant, the first stroke of a V might be almost vertical. Now, I can't tell you the pen angle in degrees that should be, but get used to looking at your nib and judging the thickness of the stroke. The thickness wants to match the other downstrokes. The second stroke can either go down or up. But usually I go up because I can be more carefree since I make the join from a stationary position at the start of the stroke. If you go down, you have to be a little more careful to get a good connection, and I prefer to be carefree and go up than careful and go down. And there's a little twist at the top to give the serif. So to explain this V stroke, you're starting on the thin edge of the pen to match the thinness of the other thin strokes, but towards the end there's a rotation, and as I rotate the nib, I also increase pressure on the left hand side of the nib, so the right hand side actually comes away in the air and does not make a stroke, and the left hand half makes this thickness at the serif, and then I pull down on the left hand corner. So if I do the movement in the air first, this is the movement, increasing pressure, pushing downwards, twisting around and pulling on the corner. I'll do that slowly here beside so you can see the stroke done slowly. Start to increase pressure, twisting around and pull down on the corner. Okay, so that shows the movement. Again, it's important to notice how much more energetic it looks when it's done fluently and with a flick. Practice it slowly to understand the movement of the nib. Practice it fast to be able to repeat it with a gesture.
The next module deals with freeing the rhythm. How to make the italic more lively and carefree rather than precise and careful. This appears to be a short menu, but if I click on this heading, a whole submenu of movies appears. I'll click the intro movie. Dangerous lines are what I call extra vigorous pen strokes that have some risk involved. Don't worry, we're not flying aircraft, so no one will die. You may mess up some sheets of paper, that's all. In return for playing on risk, we gain excitement, adrenaline, and sportsmanship in calligraphy. And the marks come alive. These are advanced pen strokes. If you do not feel ready for them, it's okay to treat this section just as informative entertainment for now. Keep working on the parts of the program most relevant to your development. These strokes may initially appear impossibly fast. Try them without the speed factor at first. Take the strokes one at a time and as you are able. After lots of practice, the movements may be retained in muscle memory, liberating you from having to think about pen angles or which half of the nib to rise on. Risk is reduced as confidence builds. This section demonstrates in great detail a range of very energetic strokes. Dangerous lines involve risk and adrenaline. Similarly, the Wild Swash Capitals heading opens a submenu with full alphabet demonstrations. Here are the next three modules. The first deals with polyrhythmic calligraphy. That's a term I've adapted for experimental calligraphy with more than one rhythm playing along the line. It's fully explained and demonstrated in the program. Here's a short sample. I've emphasized that the word minimum is great for practicing the fundamental rhythm of italic. We've taken its straight pattern of equidistant parallels and added swing, some dangerous lines, and played on the italic rhythm. Now let's introduce a polyrhythm to the word minimum. Polyrhythmic calligraphy implies more than a single rhythmic element in the pattern of writing. So I'll demonstrate adding wide extended curves to a shuffle rhythm developed from the italic pattern. This will inevitably reduce legibility, but will facilitate a more musical form. These demonstrations feature advanced pen strokes described in detail in earlier modules of the program. The new addition here will be to open a wide loop in a couple of letter spaces. No need for guidelines here, as variation in height is a desirable part of the freedom. I begin with a flicked downstroke, the thin upstroke, and a second flicked downstroke, keeping it extremely narrow because I want high contrast with this sweeping curve. Now I've returned to the compressed italic pattern. For the second M, I'll repeat the sweeping curve, but just a little smaller this time. And I'll return to the narrow pattern for the last letters. Notice how I've created an emphasis towards the beginning of the word, which gradually diminishes in scale towards the end. This diminuendo is apparent in the narrow parts as well as in the second rhythm of wide curves. The technique for the sweeping curve is similar to strokes demonstrated in the Wild Swash Capitals movies in the module on freeing the rhythm. Most importantly for long pen strokes like this at large nib sizes is to really overload the nib with a very fluid ink. Avoiding blobs is a challenge. Using a broad-edged felt tip calligraphy marker removes these ink flow problems and will allow you to concentrate on getting energetic forms. But also keep trying with pen and ink, as this can ultimately give a sharper and far more dynamic calligraphy. Let's analyze the repetitions making this polyrhythm. Apart from the two wide curves, there are three thin downstrokes. Even the large dots above the eyes repeat the diminuendo of the wide curves. The remaining strokes follow the pattern I described as a shuffle rhythm, again with a slight diminuendo from start to finish. The diminuendo seems appropriate to the cadence of spoken pronunciation. We say minimum as opposed to minimum, though such a crescendo could possibly be appropriate to other words. Of course, one need not follow the cadence of how a word is spoken, but it's worth considering. If we assign a vocal sound to each of the main rhythmic elements, then this rhythm may be articulated like this. Taketum, tiketati taketum, tati taketum. Copy this form as a beginning, but then try your own variations, and similarly articulate them vocally afterwards. Taketum, tiketati taketum, tati taketum. Taketum, tiketati taketum, tati taketum. Taketum, tiketati taketum, tati taketum. Taketum, tiketati taketum. Taketum, tiketati taketum, tati taketum. Another module is called Layering for Polyrhythms. Layering means writing on top of writing. Although legibility is reduced or even discarded, it can enrich the texture and form of calligraphy. In music, polyrhythm implies a layering of sounds with different rhythms. However, in the module on polyrhythmic calligraphy, I offered an approach where more than one rhythm play along a single layer of writing. Now let's consider layering as an additional element of polyrhythmic calligraphy. When legibility is important, layering could be disruptive. However, in music, it is accepted that the layered voices in a choir, for example, may be richer than a solo voice, even if at the expense of some intelligibility. Applications here will be for artistic calligraphy rather than functional lettering. Formal principles are offered to help you avoid the kind of mindless writing on top of writing that is seen too often. The final module, Further Inspiration, features 7 leading calligraphers. Inspiring works are discussed and analyzed, reinforcing principles explained in other parts of the program. There's also a section of bonus material. This is a 70-minute program documenting every stage of the making of a huge work of experimental calligraphy. I'm working outside on this bright winter day, and I'm laying down an 8x4-foot board in my garden. This red paper will be a background for large calligraphy, but I'll paint it first to modulate the flat color. Being outside, I'm freer to throw paint about. This is very diluted waterproof black ink. I cut the strips into small squares to drop onto my gilt paper. I also embedded a few letters into the gilding. 3 Gothic capitals with the initial letters of O Sole Mio.
It's finally complete, and overall, I'm very pleased.
The program begins with the normal mode of learning calligraphy, that is, with the copying of letter forms. Yet from the start, video demonstrations place value on dynamic gestures. It's emphasized that students need not match the speed of my pen strokes, but by witnessing the life in resulting marks, you may be encouraged to expand your own writing dynamics. A little at a time and as you are able.
Thus, serious students may be revising these videos again and again over years.
It goes beyond letter forms. Later modules emphasize processes like composing the page. Demonstrations evolve to become documentaries, revealing every stage in making improvised works of art. Dealing with error is demonstrated in various ways, including removal with surgical blades, and also by replanning on the fly.
A wide range of techniques are demonstrated, including stretching papers, color washing, and various experimental gilding processes I've developed. Several works are made live on camera from start to finish.
I think the program breaks new ground in the field of calligraphy in both form and content. Thanks for watching.
Denis Brown, calligraphy.tv.
Over and out.
Your quill skill kills.